Afternoon or evening, what is up? My name is Maarten. Welcome to the vlog, welcome to Volle Vibes, welcome to Platania, welcome to my parents and Ilona, and a sleeping Jason. So actually it's not smart that I'm shouting right now, and it's past 2 o'clock, so most people are sleeping also right now. Everything is closed here, and during that last shot that I took with my like in the water, you know, in the sea, because we're very nicely next to the sea here right now, sadly enough my shoes got soaked. I was not exactly in time to...
You expect that when you play with waves.
Yeah, it's a little wet on the front. It's okay. I will survive. It's just a little wetness. Yeah, I know. Jason is sleeping and he fell asleep like on the most bumpiest road from our house. He was like sleeping, yeah. First crying, then sleeping. Right, Grandma? And Grandpa. It's right now off season in Platania, so as you can see, we're the only car that is parked there. And usually this entire area is so full. The supermarket has like drinks outside in the fridge, and there's people sitting everywhere, the kids playing in the park. And right now it is March, end of March, almost April, and there's no one. Nix, nopus, nada, nien. There's nothing right now. Tiputa.
Supermarket mamas. Which word? Market, Oporopadropolio. It's a difficult word. I'm talking about that word, by the way.
So Ilona explained me that it's a word that means that they pretty much sell anything, but they're really like a mini supermarket, right? That's the thing.
A mini supermarket, it's called mini market.
Yeah, mini market, but it's not a mini market, it's a supermarket mamas. It's written supermarket mamas. So it's a super mini market. A mini supermarket, whatever. Oh yeah, something also I did.
Oops, I tried to park here, but yeah, I turned back again and I hit this crate.
So then we decided to park the car as far as possible away from this disaster area. So it's a beautiful day. It is 15 degrees, windy. I'm walking in my t-shirt because whenever the sun is out and you're in the sun and it's not that windy, it is perfect weather.
Perfect day to walk to the beach.
If some people wonder how I ended up, for Christ's sake, in Platania of all places in South Pelion, this is one of the reasons. We spent so many nights around here. My parents also know, I like came back in the early morning sometimes, huh? Yeah, and it's for sale now, right, this building. This used to be the shelter or the baraki. But the funny thing, it's already so empty for years. It's years it's been empty. And we used to sit here on a big table and then you had the sea there. And then you had music, and then you had there an old fallen apart house standing. But the funny thing is that this was the bar here. Right here they would have a bar, and they would like serve you drinks and everything. And right there you had some tables, and down to the water as well.
But the funniest thing is that bar is actually still,
I think it's been at least 6-7 years that it has been functioning. The stuff's still standing inside. The Focus, it's that bar that you can see here, the wooden thing up front, that is actually the bar that we used to sit on. At all the way in the back is the kitchen. Nights, days I've spent there. Also the first time I met Mariana here, by the way, because you remember Mariana from the vlogs. We actually shared notes one time here, or I shared a note with her at the bar when I met her the first time. It's a funny story. it's just a funny story. There's a lot that happened, let's put it like that here. So much actually right now that this palm tree used to be small. It was almost like the top of the palm tree was in our faces almost. Now, so many years later, it is so big, it's actually pushing this wall out of each other.
I mean, I hope it's going to survive. Hey, and back there, we used to have Michelle that lived there from Germany.
I mean, I knew so many people around here. It's just like coming to your village, even though like in winter right now, there's nobody. This is literally half of the village standing there on the beach. My parents are visiting, so that's another part of the village. So cool though. So cool.
The best feeling? Yeah. Do I need to say more? And that place, Hotel Kima, or actually Topirofani is down there. Oh, there's a cat raping another cat. whoops.
Okay. Demonetized we are right now. They're going at it. They're literally going at it. We're all of a sudden National Geographic. Anyway. At Topirofani, I told it already before as well, but now it's completely empty and the hotel is well on top. But soon enough, probably before Easter or something, they're gonna start putting the tables outside again and here as well. And I used to work here. I used to stand there with Daniel with our bottle openers all the time like this, looking at the people walking by. Remember? But the thing is that Daniel, so my buddy from, he lived now in Austria, but he was working here with me for a while and we had so much fun. It was very hard work in all honesty. I've never known that it was so hard to work actually in summer, in high season, in a restaurant like that. But it was an experience. I mean, how old was I, did I tell you? 17, some 18, 19? 18, 19, something like that. I had my driving license, I had it. 18, 19.
It's strange for a Dutch guy to be so far from his official home. And I feel more home in a place like this, actually. However, though, Platania has changed over the years.
And I don't mean the place itself. I mean, Platania doesn't change much as a village. The people have changed a little bit. Too modernized, maybe. Too much tourism. However, they live on tourism here, so. Nice, souvlaki. Very expensive?
Yes.
For Platania, for a village?
Yeah.
It was the first time that I'm actually like, kind of on the pricey side for a couple of souvlaki and some salad. Usually those things are like kind of cheap, but we paid a decent amount of money for it.
Don't look a horse in the mouth.
No, thank you, because my parents paid.
You know also what, by the way, we didn't really mention it yet, but it's the first time for Jason that he sees the sea.
No, it's not. In Volos, no. How many times he was out?
No, before. Like this, like we. I just showed him the beach. I was walking around with him and he saw the beach.
Ah.
Yeah? Yeah. Shall we touch the water?
No, not yet.
Why not?
In the summer.
In the summer, it's not too cold. But daddy stuck his feet already in there, even though it was not supposed to be happening. The weather is good enough that it already dried up. We're gonna go back onto the mountain, collect our stuff and go back to Volos probably. So this morning, or actually when I started this vlog, I took a little walk and it looked so nice and peaceful around here. It was so different than right now at this moment. It's still peaceful, but it's so different. The sun is high in the sky and I don't know, it just feels different somehow with the morning. Ilona's inside giving Jason some food. I just had a cup of coffee. We're chatting a little bit with my parents. It's nice to be up here, you know? It's such a relief sometimes to just chill a little bit. And Elsa just wants to play only.
Die stok gooien, hè? Yeah, every time when I want to pick up the stick, she will grab it in front of my eyes.
But what do I do then? I grab another stick because then she drops her own stick usually. And she's like, oh, you're gonna throw this stick?
You want this? Yeah? You want this one? Want it? Want it? Go get it. No, you're not that stupid anymore. Huh? Catch. Okay, you are.
She used to be able very well to catch sticks like that. I guess she's getting a little bit too old. Actually, she is getting a decent age now. She must be 9 or something, getting 10 almost already.
At least that's what I think. But Elsa's still looking good. She's a Malinois, by the way, a Belgian Shepherd also called.
My dad wanted to call her after the Greek secret services, Elsa. It's just, it just sounds like this dog used to be in Frozen or something. Let her go.
Everything okay?
Jason.
Everything okay? Bank business? My mom loves bank business in Greece.
Yeah, who doesn't?
It is the time again to go back to Volos, packing up the car, getting the baby and going out. Been sleeping the entire road.
Uh-huh.
The entire road. Ilona is completely tired. Ilona is that tired. I'm also kind of tired, but. And we have been half an hour or something in live stream.
Yeah.
It was a nice ride, but I'm amazed. He slept for over an hour. Over an hour. Continuously. I think it's the sound of the car and everything.
I also want the car seat like that.
Ilona also wants a car seat. Well, we'll get you one. First now, let's get inside because Durak needs to eat.
Hey, sweet. Hey. Sweet. Hello,
Mama. Oh, Mama, you woke me up.
Now, of course, it is amazing to be with your parents, but it's also very nice sometimes to come back home, right? Because this is your place. You can do whatever you want to. We can do it in my parents' place.
Can't we combine our own place with parents?
Can we not have like this house in Trojala? That you can just like lift up this house, you know, and just put it on the mountain, whatever you want, and then just like call on a helicopter and put it in the city if necessary. Also, by the way, I want to give a big shout out to Mariana because this is Durak's football. This is Durak, and Durak, eh, you little sweet boy. We left him alone because usually one night you can leave a cat alone, and we don't do it usually. Mariana always takes care of the cat, and she's like staying over and everything here. Before we left, I filled this bowl a lot, like there was a lot of food in there, you know. And Durak ate, and then I cleaned his bowl, I put a lot of food in there, and I thought like, okay, the moment that we step out of the door, I leave this bowl there, so he's already full, he'll eat this in the evening, and he'll manage for like today. Smart me, puts it in the fridge, forgets to take it out.
So that's why I say shout out to Mariana, because of her, Durak got food, huh? We love Mariana, huh? Especially you, because she brings you food.
Actually, funny to think about the fact that I met Mariana at the shelter where we were this morning and what I told you about that. So it's funny. It's a fun story that you end up meeting someone so many years ago. And after such a long time, you're back here, for example, in Volos. You like moved to Greece and everything. And you still have contact. I like it.
You're
and you're
late
good friends
for the
now.
Live stream.
What? I'm late for the live stream?
Yeah. You said 7:30.
Whoops. Live stream. Short but powerful live stream. This is also going to be the vlog for today. I hope you liked it. We had a very nice day. Ilona is right now changing Jason's diaper because he did a good job after he ate today 150 grams of lentils. Yeah, in general, those kind of peas, they do produce, let's put it like that. Anyway, thank you guys for watching this vlog. If you liked it, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button. Leave a comment down below. episode. Leave a comment down below because love to read them. We always reply with thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next one.